Hello again, everybody at YouTube, and holy crap, I know I missed the day, but yesterday was Back to the Future Day, basically. And yesterday, in case you don't know, was actually the date in Back to the Future Part 2 in which Doc and Marty went into the future in Back to the Future 2. And so it's kind of was an important day, and it shows how much we haven't invented as and how much different the future is than what 30 years ago people thought it was going to be. And so I thought it was a really cool day. I made sure I went and watched the Back to the Future movies, and today I really wanted to bring you my review of the first two Back to the Future movies. Three is going to come later because I really want to talk about these quick. So shortly after I get this video up, I'm going to have my review for Back to the Future Part 2 up, and then that's going to be it for the time being. Then I'm gonna have tons of other videos I need to get done. So, without further ado, let's get right into my review for Back to the Future. So, in case you don't know, Back to the Future is about a high schooler named Marty McFly, who kind of is like a little kind of like rebellious, almost tough, trying to be a tough guy type dude. And he has kind of a crappy home life. Like, not like his parents are bad or anything, but like his dad is always pushed around by this guy named Biff, and he just gets mad that his dad can't stand up to him and whatnot. So, and then one night, Marty, who is good friends with a doctor named Dr. Emmett Brown, goes to where the doctor is, and he shows him his new science experiment, and basically so the doc takes his dog, straps him into this car, and has the car hit up to 88 miles per hour, and once it does, it disappears. And what Marty then realizes, and what Doc tells him, is that he's traveled through time, and he basically built a time machine out of this DeLorean car, and it's now one of the most iconic time machines out there. And then shortly after this, and I'm just going to say spoilers right now because this review is filled with them. So shortly after this, these Libyans, who the doc promised he'd make a bomb for, and that's how he got the plutonium, so that he could actually travel through time because he needs a nuclear reaction, find him, and they supposedly kill him, and Marty runs away and goes into the DeLorean, not remembering that it's a time machine, and accidentally travels back to November 5th, 1955. And from there, it just ensues probably one of the best movies ever made. So with Back to the Future, it is definitely one of the best movies I've ever seen in my entire life. The characters are so great. Marty McFly is just kind of funny, morally questionable character at times in the film. And he has some actual character development over the length of the film. And then you have Dr. Emmett Brown, who is like my favorite character of the movies, even though Marty McFly is the main character. I think he's like the best character. And I do like all the characters, especially Biff Tannen. And like, he's definitely the stereotype for that like really mean, bully type character that nobody likes, and you're not meant to like him at all. And I can't remember the guy who plays him now because I'm an idiot, but he just does an amazing job as Biff. He just gives a great performance altogether. I mean, seriously. And all the characters do a great job. Why can't I think of his name? I can't think of the guy who plays George McFly either. Anyway, Christopher Lloyd, Michael J. Fox, they all do a great job in their roles, and all the characters in this movie are great. Even, like, some of the side ones, like, that are there for, like, 2 seconds can still make it, like, well, some of them are just extras, but for the most part, they all do a really good job. I remember Back to the Future was one of these movies I saw when I was little. It was purely based on my parents' recommendation that I watch it, because I remember having like one night, like all the way back when I was in elementary school, I had new movies to watch. I wanted to watch something new. I asked my mom, I was like, hey, is there something else that you think I'd like in the VHS pile? Yes, I had a VHS player. It was awesome. And she's like, oh yeah, watch this Back to the Future. You'll really like it. I'm like, okay. So I watched it. But it was like my bedtime, so I was watching while I was going to bed, and I fell asleep like a few times throughout it, so I didn't really catch the whole movie. Eventually, I did sit down one day and I watched through the whole entire movie, and I really liked it as a kid. The story is engrossing. Like, this is one of those movies you sit down, you put it in, you watch it, and it feels like it goes by in like 30 minutes in an almost 2-hour-long movie. That is incredible that a movie like this can do it, because it just, like, the sequence of events that take place in the film, they're just, whoop, they go like that, they're gone. And it's like, holy crap, that movie didn't feel long at all. And that's impressive when a movie can do that. I'm serious right now. And I genuinely like the story. It's very simplistic in its nature, but it pulls it off in such a great way that I can't help but applaud Robert Zemeckis' directing of this movie. He does an amazing job. I especially like the attention to detail in this movie, especially when Marty goes back to 1950. They make sure that, well, I mean, movies usually do this, but so it's not anything big, but they make sure that all the people are dressed in like 50s clothes, and like the people who play like the older characters in 1985 actually look younger in this 1955 that Marty is in. And I honestly really like the attention to detail in the movie. Also, the way this movie is shot is just fantastic. You know what's going on. Like, the time travel mechanic and like all the little things you'll notice throughout the movie, like, they just go together so well, and I'm just like, oh man. So like this happens and then that happens. Like, there was a shot in this movie I didn't even know existed till I watched the Honest trailer for Back to the Future 2, I think it was, or just the Back to the Future trilogy. And when Marty comes at the end of Back to the Future, when Marty comes back and he's going to try and save Doc before the Libyans get there, when he passes by the sign in front of the mall, instead of the Twin Pines Mall, it's now the Lone Pine Mall. I didn't even notice that. There's so much stuff you don't even notice, like, even after watching it multiple times. I remember when I first watched this also, I didn't even know there were sequels to it. I thought it was just its own standalone movie. Then one day, when I had a DVD player, like a few years later, we got the trilogy on DVD, and I'm like, there's two more movies? Yes! I was so pumped when I figured that out, and I watched them, and I love them. They're just all such great films, especially the first one. I think the first one has to be my favorite, just because, the second and third feel like they're almost like a combined movie, but they had to split it up because you couldn't make a 4-hour-long movie just going on and on and on, which is fine, but I really do like Back to the Future 1 because if you just take out that last scene in the movie, you wouldn't even think there would be a sequel coming after it. You'd think it's a standalone movie, and I applaud it for that. I love how isolated the movie is and how simplistic, like, the goal is. But all the twists that happen and the circumstances make it an amazing movie. I have to say, guys, that Back to the Future is pure amazingness. Guys, I want to thank you so much again for watching this review. I definitely, of course, recommend you watch the Back to the Future as well as its sequels because they're all awesome movies. And with that, guys, I just want to thank you all again for watching my channel, my videos, everything. If you like this video, do not forget to like it and subscribe if you haven't already. Comment below if you have seen this movie. What did you think of Back to the Future? And if you haven't seen Back to the Future, first off, why are you watching this review? I spoiled crap in it. And second off, well then, have you watched any of the Back to the Future films? I would be surprised if you watch the second and third after the first, but okay, whatever. And as always, guys, remember to make like a tree and get out of here.